Hallelujah, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we start our cleansing session. 奉主耶稣圣名，我们开始今天的会前唱诗。 Let's all sing hymn 95. 请大家放开赞美诗，就是乌手。 Hymn 95, 赞美诗就是乌手。 First one, 第一节。 Hymn 145. 现在再翻开赞美诗145首。 Hymn 145. 赞美诗145首。 M236, 236, 236, 236. Thank God, this concludes our hymn singing session. 感谢主今天的会前三十到此. Let's all bow our heads and pray in silence. 现在在地头默祷. Oh yeah, amen.
Good evening, everyone. Just to before we start, emailed out the handouts.
那在我们开始之前，我其实已经发邮件给大家，发出了我要今天晚上要用的 PowerPoint.
I heard that yesterday, if you don't download it on your phone to see, you may not be able to pay attention to that and listen at the same time.
那我昨天有听到说，如果你没有提前在手机上下载好的话，就没有办法一边的听一边的来看。
Yeah, so. Sorry.
所以不好意思。
Okay. Let's bow our heads in silent prayer.
我们一起低头同心默祷。
Amen.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ, we begin this evening's study of Hebrews.
奉主耶稣圣名开始，我们今天晚上对希伯来书的学习。
Let us rise up and sing hymn 96.
我们一起起立唱诗第九十六首。
The Lord Jesus Christ to guide us.
我们一起跪下，同心祷告，求主耶稣带领我们。
In the name of Lord Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, I speak.
奉主耶稣圣名开始分享。
We have mentioned that the book of Hebrews, we can discuss the five warnings.
那我之前有上一个晚上有提到，我们在希伯来书里面有五个警告。
And in Hebrews chapter 2, verse 1 to 4 talks about the first warning, do not neglect salvation.
那在希伯来书第二章第一到第四节讲到了第一个警告，就是不要忽略这么大的救恩。
Now when we read Hebrews chapter 8, verse 1 to 2, we can see that the main point of Hebrews is stated here.
那如果我们读希伯来书第八章的第一到第二节的话，我们可以看到希伯来书的中心以及核心在这两节中。
The main point of the writer writing Hebrews is stated in verse 1 and 2.
那希伯来书作者主要想要表达的观念就在第一到第二节。
And it talks about how, you know, Jesus is the high priest and the church is the true tabernacle.
讲到了我们主耶稣是大祭司以及教会就是这个真帐幕。
Now, if we look at verse 2 and verse 5,
如果我们来看第二节和第五节的话，
we can see that the true tabernacle is erected by God and not by man.
那我们看到这个帐幕，这个真帐幕是主所知的，不是人所知的。
This is an important understanding because since the true tabernacle refers to the church, then the church must be erected according to God's ways, not man's ways.
那这个观念非常的重要，因为既然真帐幕就是这个真教会，那我们要知道教会就是主所知的，而不是按照人的方式所知的。
And so therefore it is important every single one of us must allow God to erect the tabernacle through us, and we need to do so according to God's word.
那所以很重要的就是我们要允许神透过我们来支起这个真帐幕。那通过什么样的方式呢？就是通过神的话语。
Now if we know in Exodus, when God initially told Moses to build the tabernacle, Moses had to do so according to the pattern shown him on the mountain.
那我们知道在出埃及记的时候，当神指示摩西要搭帐幕的时候，我们知道摩西是在山上领受了这帐幕的搭建的方法。
Yeah, let's look at verse 5.
我们来读第五节。
God said to Moses, See that you make all things according to the pattern shown you on the mountain.
那在第五节这里写到，正如摩西将要造帐幕的时候，蒙神警戒他说，你要谨慎，做各样的物件都要照着在山上指示你的样式。
Now the pattern is important because it's revealed by God to man for man to follow.
那这个规模非常的重要，因为这是神告神启示给人的，要人来遵照他去行的。
Now the interesting thing is that how can we see the relationship between the pattern in the Old Testament and the pattern in the New Testament?
那比较有趣的是，我们怎么样能够看到旧约圣经以及新约圣经里面所说的这个规模呢？
Yeah, let's turn to Titus chapter 2 verse 7.
我们来翻到提多书第二章第七节。
Now it's important to spend some time to establish the idea of pattern and sound doctrine.
那我们需要花一些时间让自己能够有这个规模以及这个纯正话语的观念。
Yeah, let's turn to Titus chapter 2. Let's look at verse 7.
我们来翻到提多书第二章第七节。
Verse 7, please read.
第七节。你自己凡事要显出善行的榜样，在教训上要正直端庄。
Yeah, so here it talks about pattern of good works.
那在这里讲到了行善的榜样的这个规模。
The pattern of good works needs to be according to the doctrine.
那这个行善的榜样的这个规模呢，一定要建立在教训以及教义上。
Yeah, it cannot be the good works cannot be.Not based upon the good doctrine.
那行善的这个榜样不可能建立在不可能建立在不是非教义上。
Yeah. So for example, we know that in this world there are many people that do many good works, but they don't believe in one true God. They don't believe in Jesus. They don't believe in eternal life.
那我们知道在这个世界上有许多人有善行，但是他们不相信独一真神，不相信主耶稣基督，也不相信有永生。
So therefore it is not enough just to do good works in the general sense of the idea.
所以按着人的这样的思想去有善行是不够的。
Yeah, it needs to be based upon the truth.
而是要建立在真理之上。
So if you have a zeal or I have a zeal, the zeal must be based upon the truth.
所以或者是你或者我有热心的话，这样的热心一定要建立在真理上。
It must be based upon the pattern revealed by God.
一定要建立在神所启示的规模上。
Let's turn to 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 13 to 14.
那我们来读，提摩太前书。
后书。
提摩太后书。
Verse one and verse 13 and 14.
第一章第十三到第十四节。
Please read.
第十三节，你从我听那纯正话语的规模，要用在基督耶稣里的信心和爱心，常常守着。十四节。从前所交托你的善道，你要靠着那住在我们里面的圣灵，牢牢的守着。
So here it tells us we need to hold fast the pattern of sound words.
那在这里提到了我们要从要用主耶稣要守住那纯正话语的规模。
And so the pattern of sound words is the sound words that God gave to us to believe in and hold on to so that we can be saved.
那这个纯正话语的规模是要神启示给我们，让我们的牢牢的抓住，并且可以依靠着来得救的。
So today, since we believe true Jesus Church is the only true church for salvation, we must hold on to it with all our life.
那所以，既然我们今天相信真耶稣教会是唯一得救的教会，我们就要以性命这样的来牢牢抓住它。
Because the true Jesus Church, the only true church for salvation, is God's work.
因为真耶稣教会是唯一得救的教会，这是神的作为。
So if we deny this truth, we are denying God's works.
因为如果我们离弃了这样的真理的话，我们就在否认神的工作。
Now if you deny God's works, then how can you see the prophetic word of God in His scriptures?
那如果你不承认，或者说你反对神的这样的工作，你怎么能够看到神在圣经中的这样带有预言性的话语呢？
God will not reveal to you the prophecies in the Bible regarding His church.
那神也不会透过也不会让你来明白圣经中记载有关于他教会的事情。
You may be zealous for God, but you will be defiling the church.
你虽然有热心，但是你确实教会。确实教会受到了污秽。
Because you don't believe.
因为你不信。
So this is important that we have this understanding, huh?
所以我们要有这样的观念，这是非常重要的。
So it is important that we base our belief upon the 10 articles of faith and 5 basic doctrine that God has revealed to us.
那所以非常重要的是我们要能够牢牢地抓住并且将我们的信仰建立在这十大基本信仰以及五大教义上。
Let's turn to 2 Peter chapter 1 verse 20.
那我们来读彼得后书第一章的第二十节。
2 Peter chapter 1 verse 20 tells us that no scripture is of private interpretation, no prophecy is of private interpretation.
那彼得后书第一章第二十节告诉我们，圣经上没有预言是可以随意思解说的。
So that means any scripture, you cannot just make up your own interpretation.
那所以不论经上记着什么，你不可以去按着自己的私意去解说。
Let me give you a good example, right?
那我给你一个比较好的一个例子。
Yeah, so let's turn to John chapter 8.
我们来翻到约翰福音的第八章。
John chapter 8.
约翰福音第八章。
John chapter 8, if you look at verse 33.
约翰福音第八章的第三十三节。
Sorry, 44.
第三十四节。
Now, when you read this verse, it seems that Jesus is condemning these Jews who believed in him.
那如果我们按照这个表面来读的话，好像主耶稣在斥责那些相信他的犹太人。
Because Jesus said, you are of your father the devil, and the desires of your father you want to do.He was a murderer from the beginning and does not stand in the truth because there is no truth in him. When he speaks a lie, he speaks from his own resources, for he is a liar and the father of it.
44. 抱歉，是第四十四节。四十四节，你们是出于你们的父魔鬼，你们父的私欲，你们偏要行。他从起初是杀人的，不守真理，因他心里没有真理。他说谎是出于自己，因他本来是说谎的，也是说谎之人的父。
So when you read this verse, it feels as if Jesus is condemning these people who believe in him.
那所以如果我们光读这个表面的话，好像主耶稣在斥责那些所相信他的人。
But today in the True Jesus Church, we have a very good tradition is to use scripture to compare with scripture to understand another scripture.
那在真耶稣教会，我们一直用的一个非常好的一个解经方式，就是以经解经，
yeah.
用已有的经节来解释另一个经节。
Yeah. So let's turn to John chapter 12, verse 49 to 50.
那我们来读约翰福音第十二章的第四十九到第五十节。
John chapter 12, verse 49 to 50.
约翰福音十二章第四十九到第五十节。
In verse 49, it tells us that whatever Jesus says, the Father gave him command.
那在四十九节提到了主耶稣不论说什么，都是凭着差他来的父来讲的。
And if you look at verse 50, it tells us that whatever that God commands is for the purpose of everlasting life.
那我们也从第五十节了解到，不论神的命令是什么，就是为了要使我们能够得着永生。
So therefore, whatever came out of Jesus' mouth was to save people.
那所以主耶稣的不论说了什么样的话，都是为了要能够拯救人。
So we cannot forget about the scripture.
所以我们不可以忘记这个圣经里面的教训。
Because in verse 49 and 50 is so clear, this is how Jesus speaks, why Jesus speaks.
因为在这里非常清楚地提到了主耶稣是怎样说话的，以及他为什么说这些话。
Yeah, so when we come back to John chapter 8, verse 44,
那如果我们回到约翰福音第八章第四十四节的话，
we can see that when Jesus said, "You are of your father the devil," it is actually Jesus helping them to come out of deception.
那所以在四十四节主耶稣说你们是出于你们的父魔鬼，其实主耶稣是想要帮助他们脱离魔鬼的迷惑。
So if we were the believing Jews,
那如果我们是那些相信他的犹太人的话，
when we hear the words of Jesus, oh, you are of the devil, huh?
如果我们听到主耶稣对我们说你们 是魔鬼的魔鬼是你们的父，
you may feel insulted.
你可能会觉得受到了羞辱。
Jesus, I believe in you. Why are you saying such thing to humiliate me?
那主耶稣，我是这样相信你的，你为什么说这些话来使我丢失我的颜面呢？
Whatever Jesus does is for our salvation.
那不论主耶稣做什么，都是为了我们的救恩。
Let's take another example.
那我们再来看另一个例子。
Do you remember what Jesus said to Peter?
那你记得主耶稣对彼得说。
Get behind me, Satan!
撒旦退到我后边去吧。
Did Jesus condemn Peter?
那主耶稣是这样在斥责彼得吗？
不是，定他的罪吗？
主耶稣是在定彼得的罪吗？
No! He rebuked him to save him.
并不是，主耶稣这样的来斥责他是为了要能够救他。
So what is the teaching?
那我们从中得到的教训是什么？
The way Jesus erects his true tabernacle is according to his way, not our way, you know.
那就是主耶稣来建立这个真帐幕是按照他的方式，而不是按照我们的方式。
So if you only want to hear nice words, then you will not be erect part of the perfect tabernacle.
那所以如果你只想听到你想听到的话语的话，你就不属于这真帐幕里的一部分。
You don't like to listen to warning, then forget it. You are not going to be part of the true tabernacle.
因为如果你不愿意听这些警告的话，你就没有办法做这个真帐幕的一部分。
Because the way that Jesus erects his true tabernacle is through his way.
因为主耶稣支起他的真帐幕是按着他的方式。
So we find it that when we find the writer is writing to the Jewish Christians, he was writing in such a manner.
那所以当这样希伯来书的作者向当时的基督徒所写信的时候，就是按着这样的意思来写的。
He was warning them so that they can still be saved.
他这样的警告他们，希望他们还能够得救。
It was not to insult them, it was to save them.
并不是为了羞辱他们，而是为了他们能够得救。
The writer was speaking the truth so that these Jewish Christians will not be condemned.
那希伯来书的作者讲出了真理，使当时信从主耶稣的犹太人不会被定罪。
So if we go to the next slide,
那如果我们去到下一页的话，
What does it mean not to neglect our salvation?
那什么是不要离弃我们的这个救恩呢？
It means do not neglect to believe in the one true God and His law.
就是不要忘记要相信独一真神以及他的诫命。
Now we know Jesus is the one true God. He is the high priest.
那我们知道主耶稣是独一真神，也是那大祭司。
Now when we look into Hebrews chapter 10, verse 5 to 7,
那如果我们翻到希伯来书第十章第五到第七节的话，
we find it that Jesus is the one who has God's law in his heart.
我们知道主耶稣有神的诫命在他心里。
And so therefore, as the high priest, the mediator of our salvation, he is telling us the truth of God's will.
那所以主耶稣作为我们的大祭司，作为我们的中保，在告诉我们神的旨意。
And so therefore, it is important when we say we believe in Jesus, the one true God, we need to know who he is.
那所以当我们说我们相信主耶稣是那独一真神的时候，我们要认识他是谁。
We need to know what he has done and what he has said.
我们要知道他所做的以及他所说的。
We need to take it to heart.
我们要把它放到心里。
You see, the Jewish Christians, they forgot about who Jesus is.
那当时的犹太人的基督徒忘记了主耶稣是谁。
That is how bad. It's almost like today for us, we forget whether God exists or not. Something like that.
那对于今天的我们，就好比我们忘记了神到底存不存在。
That is very bad, you know.
那这其实对我们的信仰是非常不好的。
Really, in our church, some brothers and sisters, even after they receive the Holy Spirit, they question, does God exist? How strange is that?
那所以多么的奇怪，我们在教会里面有弟兄姐妹领受了圣灵之后，还会质疑神是否存在。
And so therefore, the reason why the Jewish Christians were having trouble in their faith because they forgot about who Jesus is.
那当时的犹太的基督徒，他们的信仰上遇到了困难，是因为他们忘记了主耶稣是谁。
Now, let's turn to Hebrews chapter 1.
我们来翻到希伯来书的第一章。
Verse 6 and 8 tells us that Jesus is God himself according to the scriptures.
那根据经上所记载的第六和第八节提到了主耶稣就是神本身。
And then when we come to chapter 1 verse 2 and verse 10 to 12,
那如果我们翻到希伯来书第一章的第二节以及十到十二节，
Jesus is the creator.
我们看到了主耶稣他是创造的主。
And then in chapter 5 he is the high priest according to the order of Melchizedek.
那在希伯来书第五章，我们能看到他是按照麦基洗德等次的大祭司。
He is the king and priest.
他是君王也是祭司。
And this is something that we need to bear in mind.
那这是我们心里面需要留意的。
When we worship JesusWe worship Jesus, the one true God. He's the same God in the Old Testament, the same God in the New Testament, the one and only.
那如果我们要了解到主耶稣是那唯一独一的真神的话，要了解到他是旧约里的神，也是新约里的神。
So when we look at Hebrews chapter 12, verse 29, we can see that the writer accentuates the truth of who Jesus is.
那如果我们看希伯来书第十二章第二十九节的话，作者就非常清楚地表明到了主耶稣到底是谁。
Let's turn to Hebrews chapter 12, verse 29.
我们来看希伯来书第十二章的第二十九节。
Verse 29.
第二十九节。
For our God is a consuming fire.
二十九节，因为我们的神乃是烈火。
Today we often forget that God is a consuming fire.
那今天我们常常会忘记神是烈火。
And we forget God who is a consuming fire, his law is a fiery law.
那我们忘记了神是烈火，他的诫命，他的命令都是烈火。
Yeah, we forget about it.
我们常常忘记了这件事。
So sometimes when we listen to the word of God, it just tickles our ears.
那所以有一些时候我们听到神的话的时候，好像使我们耳朵发痒。
Or maybe it doesn't even touch our heart anymore.
或者是神的话再也没有办法触碰到我们的内心。
The word of God does not seem to have authority over our life.
神的话语好像在我们的生命上并没有权柄。
If we don't have authority, if God's word does not have authority over our life, then maybe we are neglecting our salvation.
那如果神的话语在我们的生命上没有权柄的话，那我们可能是在弃绝我们的救恩。
Try it.
那我们可以这样试一试。
Try when you pray to Jesus, remember he is the consuming fire as well as the good shepherd.
那在我们向主耶稣祷告的时候，心里面要记得他是那烈火，也是那好牧人。
Before you come to church and then you come to church,When you kneel down, you're not just worshiping any old God, you are worshiping the one true God.
当你来到教会，当你跪下祷告的时候，你要知道你所敬拜的是那独一的真神。
He is the Savior, but He is also the Judge of all mankind.
他不仅是我们的救主，他也是审判一切的。
If we don't want to neglect our faith, we need to conscientiously acknowledge in our regular worship.
那如果我们不想要弃绝我们的救恩的话，就要在我们日常的敬拜中有这样的观念。
This is not only a problem that existed in Hebrews, but also in the believers in Rome.
那当时不只是在希伯来书里面的这些犹太的信徒，犹太的基督徒有这样的问题，而是罗马的基督教的信徒也有这样的问题。
Let's turn to Romans chapter 11, verse 22.
我们翻到罗马书第一十一章的第二十二节。
Romans chapter 11 verse 22.
罗马书十一章二十二节。
Here Paul says that therefore consider the goodness and severity of God on those who fell severity, but towards you goodness if you continue in His goodness, otherwise you also will be cut off.
二十二节提到了，可见神的恩慈和严厉，向那跌倒的人是严厉的，向你是有恩慈的，只要你长久在他的恩慈里，不然你也要被砍下来。
Today it is important for us to remember God is goodness, but He also has a severity side as well.
那所以今天我们要留意，神不仅有恩慈，也是严厉的。
We need to take it to heart.
那我们要把这个放在心中。
You will find when you take this to heart completely, your faith will grow faster.
当你完全地把这样的观念放到心中并且接受的话，你的信仰就会成长得更快。
So when we come back to Hebrews chapter 2, we know that Jesus is bringing many sons to glory.
那我们如果翻回到希伯来书第二章的话，我们要知道主耶稣要领许多的儿子进到荣耀里去。
In order not to neglect our salvation, what has Jesus gone through in order to bring us into glory?
那为了要让我们不离弃这个救恩，主耶稣到底做了什么来使我们能够带进我们进荣耀里去呢？
We know that Jesus went through suffering.
那我们知道主耶稣受苦。
Let's turn to Hebrews chapter 2 verse 9 to 10 and verse 18.
那我们来翻到希伯来书第二章第九到第十节以及第十八节。
Hebrews chapter 2 verse 9, 10 and verse 18.
那希伯来书第二章第九、第十和第十八节。
Please read.
第九节，唯独见那成为比天使小一点的耶稣，因为受死的苦，就得了尊贵、荣耀为冠冕，叫他因着神的恩，为人人尝了死味。第十节，原来那为万物所属、为万物所本的，要领许多的儿子进荣耀里去，使救他们的元帅因受苦难得以完全，本是合宜的。第十八节， 他自己既然被试探而受苦，就能搭救被试探的人。
Today when we believe in Jesus, we are very touched. God suffered for me.
那今天我们知道主耶稣救我们，我们非常的感动，因为神为我们而受苦。
He is the Son of God. He suffered for us for our salvation.
那主耶稣是神的儿子，他为了我们救恩的缘故受苦。
Now, in order for Jesus to bring us into glory, we also need to suffer with him.
那主耶稣既然要将我们领到他的荣耀里，我们就要与他一同受苦。
How do we know this to be true?
那我们怎么样知道这是真实的呢？
Let's turn to Romans chapter 8.
我们来翻到罗马书的第八章。
Romans chapter 8 verse 15 to 17.
罗马书第八章第十五到第十七节。
Verse 15 talks about that we have not received the spirit of a bondage again to fear, but we have received the spirit of adoption by which we cry out, Abba, Father.
第十五节提到了，我们所受的不是奴仆的心，人就害怕，所受的乃是儿子的心，因此我们呼叫阿爸父。
The Spirit Himself bears witness with our spirit that we are children of God.
圣灵与我们的心同证，我们是神的儿女。
And verse 17, and if children, then heirs, heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ. If indeed we suffer with Him, that we may also be glorified together.
十七节，既是儿女，便是后嗣，就是神的后嗣，和基督同作后嗣。如果我们和他一同受苦，也必和他一同得荣耀。
So how do we know Jesus is bringing us into glory when our heart is willing to suffer with Jesus?
那我们怎么样知道神要将我们带进荣耀中呢？就是当我们的心愿意和主耶稣一同受苦的时候。
But sometimes we may not be willing to suffer with Jesus.
但是有一些时候我们并不愿意和主同受苦。
Why is that?
那为什么会这样呢？
Hebrews chapter 2 verse 15 gives us a clue.
那希伯来书第二章的第十五节告诉我们一个原因。
Let's turn to Hebrews chapter 2, verse 15.
我们翻到希伯来书第二章的第十五节。
When Jesus came into this world, he came to free us from the one who had the power of death, that is the devil.
那第十五节告诉我们，其实主耶稣来的时候是要释放我们，释放我们要败坏那掌死权的，就是魔鬼。
Now, if you look at verse 15.He Jesus come to release us, those who were fear of death were all our lifetime subject to bondage.
那第十五节特别提到，并且要释放那一生因怕死而为奴仆的人。
So today, why is it that we are not willing to suffer with Jesus?
那今天为什么我们不愿意同主耶稣一起受苦呢？
Because we're still scared of dying.
因为我们怕死。
We're not totally believing. If we follow Jesus, we suffer with him, we die with him, we will be glorified.
因为我们不是完全的相信，如果我们和主耶稣一同受苦，一同死的话，也会和他一同得着荣耀。
That's why sometimes we keep God's commandments half-half.
那所以有时候我们只守神诫命的一半。
Because we're still scared, isn't it?
因为我们的内心还是害怕的。
So today we need to suffer with Jesus to break through the spirit of bondage.
那所以今天我们就要和主耶稣一起受苦，来突破这个为奴的心。
Really thank God.
真的感谢神。
There was a family who did not observe the Sabbath day properly for many years.
那有一个家庭，许多年都没有按着正确的方式去守安息日。
And so the children attend the youth theological.
他们的孩子参加了这个青年神训班。
So the children encourage the parents, we need to keep the Sabbath day properly.
所以这个里面的孩子反过来去勉励父母说，我们要按着正确的方式来守安息日。
So a few more years later, the parents surrender. Okay, we must keep the Sabbath day properly.
那过了几年之后，家长就妥协了，说我们应该要正确的方式去守安息日。
But do you know what?
那你知道什么吗？
They did not earn more money.
他们并没有赚得更多。
No, sometimes they earn even less than before. They keep the Sabbath day properly.
那有可能，但是有时候他虽然守安息日，按着正确的方式守安息日，赚到的钱却比以前少。
But do you know what they say?
但你知道他们说什么吗？
Even though we don't earn more money, we have spiritual joy.
虽然我们赚的没有以前多，但是我们有属灵上的喜乐。
They obey God's will.
他们遵从了神的命令。
They seem to suffer physically.
他们好像在肉体上是受苦的，
But yet they are holy with God.
但他们却可以和神一同圣洁。
They are not scared.
他们不再胆怯。
Because they trust God will provide.
因为他们相信神必预备。
And God provide them spiritual blessing when they keep God's commandments.
那当他们守神的诫命的时候，神就赐给他们了属灵的祝福。
Yeah, so they are not they are freed from the spirit of bondage.
那所以他们不再是为奴仆的人了。
So this is actually quite good for us.
那其实这样对我们来说是好的。
When we want to advance in faith, what is holding us back?
当我们信仰想要再更前进一步的时候，什么会绊我们的脚，使我们不能够往前呢？
Let's turn to Hebrews chapter 12, verse 5 to 11.
那我们翻到希伯来书第十二章的第五到第十一节。
Now we find it that why are we not willing to suffer with Jesus?
那为什么我们有时候不愿意和主耶稣一同受苦呢？
Because deep down inside our heart, we do not want to partake of God's holiness.
因为内心深处我们并不愿意与神的圣洁有份。
And so that is why God uses suffering to help us partake of his holiness.
那这就是为什么神用各样的苦难来使我们经历这个苦难，来帮助我们。
So that we can partake of his holiness.
让我们可以与他的圣洁有份。
Now how do we know this to be true? Verse 10.
那我们怎么知道呢？在第十节。
Verse 10.
第十节。
Please read.
深深的父都是随己意管教我们，唯有万灵的父管教我们，是要我们得益处，使我们在地上，在他的圣洁上有份。
So since the characteristic of Jesus, he went through suffering to save us.
那所以既然主耶稣他受了苦来拯救我们。
Then if we want to not neglect our salvation, we say, God, please help me, chastise me if I am not have the heart to be holy like you.
那所以我们为了要不离弃我们的救恩的话，就要求神来，当我们不愿意与他的圣洁上有份的时候，来管教我们。
Yeah, have you made that prayer before?
你有这样的祷告过吗？
Have you prayed like that?
你有这样的祷告吗？
You pray, God, I don't have the Holy Spirit, give me the Holy Spirit.
你有这样祷告过，神，我没有圣灵，所以求你赐给我圣灵。
Maybe we don't pray, God, I'm not holy enough, please punish me and so that I can suffer and then I will partake of your holiness.
但是呢，我们却从来没有这样祷告说，神，我不够圣洁，所以请你管教我，使我吃苦，这样我才能够醒悟过来与你的圣洁有份。
There was a sister who said,
那有一个姐妹这样说，
哎呀， my husband's faith is very bad, you know.
那我的丈夫的这个信仰非常的不好。
He become very lazy.
他变得非常的懒惰。
So she said to the mother.
那所以他跟母亲说。
Mother, can I pray to God and say, ask God to give him a little bit of punishment so that he can be more earnest in his faith? Can I pray like that?
他就问他的母亲说，我可以这样祷告，来为我的先生这样祷告，让神稍微惩罚他一下，让他的信仰能够再往前一步吗？
Oh, I say, wow, this is a sister, very good prayer.
那我就说这个姐妹的祷告是非常好的。
Because the wife loved the husband, you see.
那是因为这个妻子爱她的丈夫。
It's good for us to pray to God so that we can be partake of the suffering to be more holy.
那我们这样的祷告 求主使我们与他的受苦有份，来使我们更加的圣洁，这样的祷告是好的。
Now if we look at Hebrews chapter 2 verse 9,
那如果我们翻到希伯来书第二章第九节的话，
we can see that Jesus was made a little lower than the angels.
那我们看到主耶稣成为比天使小一点的。
Now this is a very significant fact.
那这是一个非常重要的事实。
Why? Because God is the most high God and he became lower than his angel.
那为什么呢？因为主耶稣是那至高的神，他却比天使小了一点。
He made himself lower.
他却是使自己成为比天使小一点的。
Now, if you look at chapter 7, verse 28,
那如果我们看第七章的第二十八节的话，
we can see that Jesus was appointed.
那我们再看到这里，主耶稣被任命。
对， he was appointed.
他是被任命。
So, what does this teach us today?
那这告诉我们什么呢？
Now remember at the beginning, oh, we mentioned that when we serve God, we need to serve according to the pattern, isn't it?
那我们在一开始的时候提到，如果我们想要侍奉神的话，就要按照他的规模来侍奉。
Yeah, that means we need to wait for Jesus to appoint us.
那所以我们要等主耶稣来差我们。
Jesus was appointed. He did not take the glory to himself.
那主耶稣是这样的被立，他没有自取他的荣耀。
He didn't.
他并没有这样做。
Let's turn to Hebrews chapter 5, verse 4.
我们来翻到希伯来书第五章的第四节。
Hebrews chapter 5, verse 4.
希伯来书第五章第四节。
When we are serving in church,
当我们在教会中侍奉的时候，
are we willing to be appointed or we take the honor to ourselves?
那我们是愿意被教会差派，还是我们自己去取呢？
Sometimes our hearts may have a little bit of pride. You know, we can't wait. Oh, I feel I'm very gifted. And God wants to use me. I know God wants to use me. The church must use me.
那有时候我们心里面有那一点点的骄傲，觉得我非常的有恩赐，所以主耶稣一定愿意用我，教会一定愿意用我。
And but Jesus is different, you know.
但是主耶稣是不一样的。
If you look at Hebrews chapter 5 verse 8,
如果我们看希伯来书五章第八节的话，
Hebrews chapter 5 verse 8,
希伯来书第五章第八节，
verse 8,
第八节，
Though he was a son, yet he learned obedience by the things which he suffered.
第八节，他虽为儿子，还是因所受的苦难学了顺从。
He suffered first.
所以主耶稣是先受苦了。
He was appointed.
他被差要受苦。
He did not take important.
所以今天这是非常重要的。
When we serve in the church,
当我们在教会中侍奉的时候，
we need to suffer with Jesus.
那我们要与主耶稣一同受苦。
But we need to learn His humility.
但是我们却要学习他的谦卑。
We wait to be appointed.
我们要等教会来差派我们。
We don't take the honor to ourselves.
我们不是自取这样的荣耀。
Then we are safe.
这样我们就可以得救。
Then I will not be tempted to be like the devil who wants to be high like God.
那这样我们就不会我们就不会受到迷惑，来想要和魔鬼一样，甚至想要比神高。
Yeah, we won't have that in temptation.
我们不会有那样的心思。
It is better to be safe than sorry.
那我们更好，我们宁可是要安全，也不要留任何的遗憾。
Now, when we look at Hebrews chapter 2, verse 15,
那如果我们来读希伯来书第二章第十五节的话，
Now, Hebrews chapter 2, verse 15 tells us that Jesus was able to release those who through fear of death were all their lifetime subject to bondage.
那十五节特别提到了主耶稣能够释放那一生因怕死而为奴仆的人。
Today we ask this question.
那今天我们问这样的问题。
Do we need Jesus to release us from the fear of being exposed?
那我们要求主耶稣来释放我们怕这样被暴露的情况下这样的心吗？
What do I mean by this?
那我这样说是什么意思呢？
Let's turn to John chapter 3.
那我们来翻到约翰福音第三章。
John chapter 3 verse 20 to 21.
约翰福音第三章第二十到第二十一节。
John chapter 3 verse 20 to 21.
约翰福音三章二十到二十一节。
We find it that we don't like to be exposed, huh?
那我们知道我们并不愿意被这样的暴露。
不是那个 ，if you just read the verse 20 and 21。
那我们如果读第二十和第二十一节的话，凡作恶的便恨光，并不来救光，恐怕他的行为受责备；但行真理的必来救光，要显明他所行的是靠神而行。
Today, if we have done something wrong and we are exposed, we feel very bad, isn't it?
那今天如果我们做了很多做了错的事情被揭露的话，我们可能会感到非常的感觉非常不好。
One time.
那有一次。
I went to visit a member.
那我去拜访一位信徒。
The first thing he said to me, preacher, what do you want? Have I done something wrong?
那他第一句对我说的话就是，传道，你来找我做什么？我是不是做错了什么？
He has some stress.
他有一些压力。
I just went to out of care and love to visit him. That's all.
那我只是带着关怀和爱心去拜访他而已。
Why does he have this fear? Huh? Why does he have this stress?
那他为什么有这样的恐惧？为什么有这样的这个压力呢？
Because it deep down inside there's something hidden. Huh?
那因为在他内心的深处有一些被隐藏的。
Otherwise, why are you scared?
那要不然他怕什么呢？
Yeah, thank God.
那感谢神。
It was true.
那也是真的。
The brother had weakness.
那所以这个
弟兄，
这个弟兄
，He had weakness.
他有软弱。
Later on, he confessed.
那之后他就跟我说了。
But thank God.
但是感谢神。
He repented.
他悔改了。
God forgave him.
神原谅了他。
Now he's spiritually stronger.
那现在属灵上他更加的健壮了。
So all of us needs to be released, you know.
那所以我们其实所有的人都要得到释放。
So if we do not want to neglect our salvation, we need to let Jesus release us from our bondage.
如果我们不想要离弃我们的救恩的话，就要允许主耶稣来释放我们，脱离我们的捆绑。
Sometimes as children, we do something wrong, we say something wrong, we don't want to be exposed.
那有些时候作为儿女，我们做错了什么或者说错了什么，不愿意这样的被揭露出来。
We are defiant of our parents.
因为我们在我们的父母之前，在我们的父母前面，我们自我保护意识非常的强。
Defiant. 反抗。
就是非常的会反抗。
Yeah. I am right, you are wrong.
那我是对的，你是错的。
And there's no peace in the family, right?
那在 家庭中就没有这样的平安。
This tells us we need to be exposed and to be released.
那这就告诉我们需要被揭露出来，并且要能够得着释放。
So the thing is, if we do not allow Jesus to release us from this bondage,
那所以如果我们不允许主耶稣来救我们脱离这样的捆绑的话，
what will happen?
那会发生什么呢？
We are actually in opposition to God.
那我们其实跟神是在对立的。
Yeah, let's turn to 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 24 to 26.
那我们来翻到提摩太后书第二章第二十四到第二十六节。
2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 24 to 26.
提摩太后书第二章第二十四到第二十六节。
Here it talks about someone who has been taken captive by the devil.
那在这里提到了被魔鬼所掳去的人。
They lost their senses.
他们失去了他们这样的意识。
They have been taken captive to do the devil's will.
他们被魔鬼任意的掳去来行他的旨意。
And if you look at verse 25, they are in opposition to the truth.
那我们看到他们是抵挡真道的。
Yeah. So therefore, we find that when a person is in bondage, they are opposing God, not just opposing people, you know.
所以当一个人在捆绑之中的时候，他不仅是在抵挡人，他更是在抵挡神。
So we find that when a wife is not walking according to the truth of being a wife.
那如果一个作为妻子的没有按照真理去行去做一名妻子的话
，It seems that she is opposed to the husband.
那她好像跟丈夫是抵抗的。
But actually, she is not willing to become a wife according to the truth.
但在更深一层的层面，她却不愿意按着真理去做一名妻子。
Yeah. And so she is opposing God, opposing the husband, and ruining the children.
那所以她在抵挡丈夫，抵挡神，也在毁了她的儿女。
This is a very dangerous position to be in.
那在这样的一个位置，是一个非常危险的一个位置。
So it doesn't matter whether we are husband, whether we are wife, or whether we are children.
那所以不论我们是做儿女的、做丈夫的，还是做妻子的
，All of us needs to walk according to the truth.
我们全都要按着真理去行。
If we don't,
若是我们不这样做的话
，What will happen?
那我们会发生什么呢
？Let's look at Jude verse 6.
那我们来翻到犹大书的第六章。
Jude verse 6.
犹大书第六节。
Now Jude verse 6 talks about the fallen angel.、Huh?
那犹大书第六节提到了那堕落的天使。
Yeah, if you look at verse 6.、Huh?
我们来读第六节。
Verse 6.
第六节。
But and the angels who did not keep their proper domain but left their own abode, he has reserved in everlasting chains under darkness for the judgment of the great day.
第六节又有不守本位离开自己住处的天使，主用锁链把他们永远拘留在黑暗里，等候大日的审判。
So when our thoughts is full of darkness.
那当我们的想法充满黑暗的时候
，Our heart is full of darkness.
我们的内心充满黑暗的时候
，We're not willing to walk in love.
我们不愿意行在爱中。
Love God, love man.
来爱神爱人。
Then God will reserve us in everlasting chains under darkness for the judgment of the great day.
那主就会用锁链把我们永远拘留在黑暗里，等候大日的审判。
So when you know your heart is in darkness,
那所以当你知道你的心里面有黑暗的时候
，When you're full of anger,
当你充满这样子的愤怒的时候
，You're not willing to forgive,
当你不愿意去原谅的时候
，Don't forget,
你不要忘记
，You have a choice.
你有一个选择。
You can go to Jesus to be released from this bondage.
那你可以去到主耶稣那里，主耶稣会将你从这样的锁链中释放。
Or you can forever be in bondage forever.
那或者你可以永远这样被锁住。
So therefore we find it that Jesus does everything by God's grace, you know.
那我们知道主耶稣因着恩典，神的恩典来做这一切。
This is one point that we can find in Hebrews chapter 2 verse 9.
那这就是我们在希伯来书第二章第九节里面所能够看到的。
Let's turn to Hebrews chapter 2 verse 9.
我们来读希伯来书第二章第九节。
Verse 9. But we see Jesus, who was made a little lower than the angels for the suffering of death, crowned with glory and honor, that he, by the grace of God, might taste death for everyone.
第九节，唯独见那成为比天使小一点的耶稣，因为受死的苦，就得了尊贵，荣耀为冠冕，叫他因着神的恩，为人人尝了死味。
By the grace of God, isn't it? Is it say in Chinese?
那在这里提到了主耶稣是因着神的恩
，by the grace of God。 This is something very strange because we say, oh, we do things by the grace of God, right?
那因为这样听上去非常的奇怪, 我们虽然说我们是因着神的恩典,
but for Jesus to do everything by God's grace,
但是主耶稣却要因着神的恩典来行这一切的事,
what does this mean?
那这是什么意思呢?
He was very happy to do it.
就代表他行这一切的事都非常的乐意,
it's because God gave him the duty to do it.
因为神给了他这样的责任,
let's turn to 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 20. Huh?
那我们来翻到彼得前书第二章的第二十节。
This is very touching.
那这其实是非常令我们感动的。
If you look at 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 20,
彼得前书第二章的第二十节,
here it talks about verse 20. Huh?
第二十节。
For what credit is it when you are beaten for your fault, you take it patiently? But when you do good and suffer, if you take it patiently, this is commendable before God.
第二十节, 你们若因犯罪受责打, 能忍耐, 有什么可夸呢? 但你们若因行善受苦, 能忍耐, 这在神看是可喜爱的。
Verse 21.
第二十一节,
For to this you were called, because Christ also suffered for us, leaving us an example that you should follow his footsteps.
21节, 你们蒙召原是为此, 因基督也为你们受过苦, 给你们留下榜样, 叫你们跟随他的脚踪行。
Here it tells us, if we have done wrong, we need to shoulder the responsibility.
那在这里提到了, 若是我们有过犯的话, 我们就要能够承担那个过犯所带来的责任。
But if we do good and suffer,
那我们若因行善而受苦的话,
we are not just fulfilling our calling,
那我们并不只是在完成神呼召我们的旨意,
we are following in Jesus' footsteps,
我们却在跟随主耶稣的脚踪去行。
So today, if you want to be erected with the true, according to the true tabernacle, right?
那所以今天若是我们想要成为真帐幕的一部分来被立起的话,
don't just do the things that you find easy,
不只要做你认为能够简单的事情,
we need to learn to do good and suffer,
我们要能够学习因为行善而受苦,
just like Jesus,
就像主耶稣一样。
So when Jesus gives you a job to do in church, to do good and suffer,
那若是主耶稣让你来在教会中做一样圣工,因行这样的善而受苦的话,
then it is God's grace gift to you,
那就是神赐给你的恩典。
Meaning this,
那就是带有这样的意思,
He gives you a chance to experience how He suffered for you,
他赐给你一个机会, 让你能够体会他是如何为你受过苦。
Yeah. He gives you an opportunity to set an example for other people to follow,
那他也给你一个机会, 让你为其他人留下榜样, 好, 要叫他们也照着这样去行。
We do it by God's grace.
那我们是因着神的恩这样去做。
God gave us this opportunity to experience how much Jesus suffered for us.
那神给我们这样的机会, 来让我们体验主耶稣为我们受了多少的苦。
And we also become God's grace to other people to show other people.
那我们也能够成为其他人能够看得到的恩典。
Otherwise, how will the true tabernacle be set up and perfected?
那不然的话, 这个真帐幕怎样能够支起, 怎样能够完全呢?
How can it be?
那怎么能够这样去做呢?
So therefore, we need to learn from Jesus.
那所以我们要学习主耶稣,
do everything by God's grace.
因着神的恩去行这一切的事。
Now, this last point is very important.
那这最后的一部分也非常的重要。
Now, let's turn back to Hebrews.
那我们翻回到希伯来书,
Hebrews chapter 2 verse 11.
希伯来书第二章的第十一节。
Hebrews chapter 2 verse 11.
希伯来书第二章的第十一节。
Verse 11.
第十一节。
Verse 11.
十一节。
For both he who sanctifies and those who are being sanctified are all of one, for which reason he is not ashamed to call them brethren.
第十一节, 因那使人成圣的和那些得以成圣的都是出于一, 所以他称他们为弟兄并不以为耻。
Now, we know that salvation is Jesus bring us into glory, right?
那我们知道救恩就是主耶稣将我们带进荣耀中。
Can I ask you a question?
那我可以问大家一个问题吗？
When has glory begun?
那这样的荣耀从何时开始呢？
Has your glory begun?
你的荣耀开始了吗？
Has my glory begun?
我的荣耀开始了吗？
Yes, it has.
是的。
Hi, why?
为什么呢？
Because Jesus already made us holy, isn't it true?
因为主耶稣已经使我们成圣了，不是吗？
Before we were sinners, now we are baptized, we are sons of God. Are we holy? Yes, we are.
那所以从前我们是犯罪的，但是在经过受洗之后，我们成为了神的儿女，我们是圣洁的吗？我们是的。
Now, if you do not see that you have been made holy and the glory has already begun,
那如果我们不看自己是已经得以成为圣洁的了，如果我们不看这样的荣耀已经开始了的话，
then you will not value your salvation.
你就不会珍惜你的救恩。
You just believe, glory is in the future when I die and I go to heaven.
那你只相信荣耀是在以后，我死了以后我能够进天国。
It's not true.
其实不是这样的。
Let me give you an understanding, huh?
那我来给你一些更多的一个理解。
Today, if we are joined to the church of God, is that our glory?
那今天如果我们与神的教会联合，这是我们的荣耀吗？
Let's turn to Ephesians chapter 5 verse 25.
我们来读以弗所书第五章第二十五节。
Ephesians chapter 5 verse 25.
以弗所书五章第二十五节。
Ephesians chapter 5 verse 25.
以弗所书第五章第二十五节。
Here it says, Husband, love your wife just as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for her.
二十五节，你们做丈夫的要爱你们的妻子，正如教会基督爱教会，为教会舍己。
So are we part of the church?
那我们是属于教会的一部分吗？
Is the church the wife of Jesus?
那教会是主耶稣的妻子吗？
If we are part of the church, are we not part of his wife?
那我们若是教会的一部分的话，我们难道不是他妻子的一部分吗？
Isn't that the beginning of our glory?
那其实这不就是我们荣耀的开始吗？
If you don't believe, if you don't believe, of course you neglect your salvation.
那如果你不是这样相信的话，你当然会不重视你的救恩。
Yeah, let's look at the second one.
那我们再来读第二个部分。
Glory is sanctification completed.
荣耀是成圣的完成。
How do we know this?
那我们怎么知道呢？
Let's turn to Ephesians chapter 5 verse 27, huh?
我们来读以弗所书第五章第二十七节。
Ephesians chapter 5 verse 27.
以弗所书第五章第二十七节。
That he might present her to himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that she should be holy and without blemish.
二十七节，可以献给自己。做个荣耀的教会，毫无玷污、皱纹等类的病，乃是圣洁、没有瑕疵的。
So if you say, oh, I don't know if I will be part of the perfect church.
那如果你这样说，我不知道我是否会成为这完全的教会的一部分。
That means you deny you are already part of the glorious church, no?
那你现在就已经在否认你是属于这荣耀的教会的一部分。
Because Jesus has qualified us to be made holy, the glory has already begun.
那是因为主耶稣已经使我们可以圣洁，所以这个荣耀已经开始了。
And so therefore the whole plan of God is for the glory is sanctification completed, means that we will become part of the perfect church.
那所以神的整个计划就是荣耀是成圣的完成，就是我们会成为这完全的教会的一部分。
So therefore, since that is God's plan for His whole church and we are part of His church,
那既然这是神对于他教会的计划，那我们又是他教会的一部分。
Then what can we learn from this?
那我们可以从中学到什么呢？
And let's turn back to Hebrews, huh?
我们再回到希伯来书。
Hebrews chapter 2, huh?
希伯来书第二章。
Hebrews chapter 2.
希伯来书第二章。
Hebrews chapter 2, let's look at verse 11.
我们来读第十一节。
Now, don't forget, Jesus has made us one with him.
那不要忘记主耶稣已经使我们和他成为一。
So when we are inside Jesus, Jesus is not ashamed of us, you know. He's not ashamed to call us brethren.
那所以因为我们已经在基督里，所以主耶稣并不以叫我们弟兄为耻。
He's not ashamed of us.
所以他并不会以我们为耻。
Today, is it sometimes we are ashamed of ourselves, isn't it?
那有些时候我们会自己的以自己为耻。
Yeah, with so many weakness, so many bad, yeah.
那我们会觉得自己有如此多的软弱，如此多不好的地方。
But Jesus is not ashamed of us.
但是主耶稣并不以我们为耻。
How do we know this to be true?
那我们怎么知道这是真实的呢？
Now, if you look at Jesus, how Jesus deal with his disciples.
那如果我们看主耶稣是如何和他的门徒联系的话。
不是，看主耶稣怎么对待他的门徒。
那如果我们看主耶稣是如何对待他的门徒的话。
If you look at Luke chapter 24.
那我们翻到路加福音的第二十四章。
How many years did Jesus spend with the disciples?
那主耶稣和他的门徒同住了几年呢？
3 years.
他们同住了三年。
3 years they listened to the words of Jesus.
那三年他们听了主耶稣的话。
Did the disciple receive power to perform signs and miracles? Yes, they did.
那主耶稣这样使门徒得着能力来行那些神迹奇事吗？是的。
Did they preach the gospel?
他们是否传福音了？
Did they hear Jesus telling them, I am going to suffer and die and I will resurrect from the dead? Did they know?
那他们知道吗？他们有听到主耶稣说我要即将受苦，即将被钉十字架，然后会复活吗？
They heard it.
他们是听到了。
But what happened when Jesus resurrected?
但是当主耶稣复活之后发生了什么呢？
Let's turn to Luke chapter 24.
我们来翻到路加福音第二十四章。
Luke chapter 24.
路加福音二十四章。
Verse 25 to 27.
第二十五到第二十七节。
What did Jesus say to these two disciples?
那主耶稣和这两位门徒说了什么呢？
O foolish ones and slow of heart to believe in all that the prophets have spoken. Verse 26.
26.
Or not the Christ to have suffered these things and to enter into his glory. Verse 27.
27节。
And beginning at Moses and all the prophets, he exposed to them in all the scripture the things concerning himself.
在这里提到无知的人呐，先知所说的一切话，你们的心信得太愚钝了。基督这样受害又进入他的荣耀，岂不是应当的吗？二十七节，于是从摩西和众先知起，凡经上所指着自己的话，都给他们讲解明白了。
How did Jesus treat his disciples?
那主耶稣是怎么样对待他的门徒的呢？
They were foolish and slow of heart to believe.
那他们的心信得非常的迟钝。
Today, if we do not want to neglect our salvation,
那今天如果我们不想要忽略我们自己的救恩的话，
we need to admit to Jesus, I am foolish and slow of heart to believe in the Bible.
那我们就要在主耶稣的面前承认我们是无知的，并且我们的心信圣经上的话信得太迟钝了。
Because Jesus is willing to teach us if we are humble and ask God to teach us.
因为如果我们谦卑下来求神来教导我们的话，主耶稣非常乐意地帮助我们。
But if we say we are wise but we are fools, we are saying I believe already, but we are slow of heart to believe, then we are neglecting our salvation.
那如果我们其实是愚钝的，但是我们却说自己是知道的，我们已经知道自己的心性的太迟钝的话，我们其实是在离弃我们自己的救恩。
Today we need to understand.
那今天我们要能够明白。
If the apostles, right, had gone through such immaturity,
那如果当时的门徒已经经过了这么不成熟的阶段，
but Jesus was not ashamed of them, but helped them.
那主耶稣却并没有以他们为耻，反倒是帮助了他们。
We need to let Jesus help us.
那我们就要能够让主耶稣来帮助我们。
Otherwise, if we say, No, I am fully mature, I've got no spiritual problem.
那如果我们说我们已经完全的属灵上成熟了，并没有属灵上的问题的话，
Then we neglect our salvation.
那我们就是在忽略我们的救恩。
Let's turn to Hebrews chapter 7, huh?
那我们翻到希伯来书的第七章。
Hebrews chapter 7,
希伯来书第七章。
Hebrews chapter 7 verse 25, huh?
希伯来书第七章的第二十五节。
Hebrews chapter 7 verse 25.
希伯来书七章二十五节。
Here it talks about Jesus.
那在这里讲到了关于主耶稣的事。
Therefore he is also able to save to the uttermost those who come to God through him, since he always lives to make intercession for them.
二十五节，凡靠着他进到神面前的人，他都能拯救到底，因为他是长远活着替他们祈求。
So here it tells us that Jesus is interceding for us.
那在这里提到了主耶稣为我们祈求。
Today is Jesus interceding for you, interceding for me.
那今天主耶稣也为你为我祈求吗？
Why is Jesus still interceding for me if I'm already perfect?
那如果我今天已经完全了的话，主耶稣为什么还要为我祈求呢？
So it must be, since Jesus is still interceding for me, there are imperfections in me.
那所以主耶稣既然今天还在为我祈求的话，我身上还有不完全的地方。
I have not been saved to the uttermost yet.
我还没有 那样的完全的被他所拯救。
So I still need Jesus very much.
所以我还非常的需要我的主耶稣。
Yeah. So remember, Jesus is interceding for us means we are still not perfect yet.
那所以在这里我们知道主耶稣既然还在替我们祈求，我们就并没有完全。
So often we say, oh, Jesus pray for me, because I'm spiritually weak.
那我们常常会说主耶稣为我们祈祷，为我们祈求，是因为我们属灵上软弱。
And we just leave it like that, isn't it?
那我们就把它这样的情况就放在一边。
But today when we know Jesus is interceding for us before we are not perfect, then we need to rely on God to become perfect.
那今天如果我们知道主耶稣是因为我们不完全而为我们祈求的话，我们就要能够依靠神去渐渐变得完全。
You see, Jesus is so nice to us.
那我们主耶稣对我们实在是非常的好。
Let's turn to Hebrews chapter 12.
我们来翻到希伯来书第十二章。
Hebrews chapter 12 verse 25.
希伯来书十二章第二十五节。
Hebrews chapter 12 verse 25.
希伯来书第十二章第二十五节。
Verse 25.
第二十五节。
See that you do not refuse him who speaks, for if they did not escape who refuses him who spoke on earth, how much more shall we not escape if we turn away from him who speaks from heaven?
二十五节，你们总要谨慎，不可弃绝那向你们说话的，因为那些弃绝在地上警戒他们的，尚且不能陶醉，何况我们违背那从天上警戒我们的呢？
Can I ask you a question?
那我可以问大家一个问题吗？
When you imagine God is speaking to you,
当你想象神在对你说话的时候，
Do you expect God to, full of wrath, shout in your face and wake you up from your sleep?
那你是指望神对着你的面大声的喊叫，或者是把你从睡梦中叫醒吗？
Let's turn to 2 Corinthians.
我们来翻到哥林多后书。
I think you may cry after you read this verse.
那可能我们在读完这一节的时候可能会哭。
Let's turn to 2 Corinthians chapter 5.
哥林多后书的第五章。
2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 20.
哥林多后书第五章的第二十节。
2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 20. Now then we are ambassadors for Christ as though God were pleading through us. We implore you on Christ's behalf be reconciled to God.
二十节，所以我们做基督的使者，就好像神借我们劝你们一般，我们替基督求你们与神和好。
Paul was begging the believers to be reconciled to God, right?
那在当时保罗求当时的信徒与神和好。
Who was Paul begging on behalf of?
那保罗是替谁这样求呢？
He was pleading on behalf of Jesus, right?
那他是替主耶稣这样的来求他们与神和好。
So that means Jesus was also begging, come on, come on, come back, be reconciled.
那所以今天主耶稣也是在这样求我们回来，求我们与神和好。
Today we never think like that, you know.
那我们今天从来都没有这样的想过。
We just pray our prayer, we don't even care about how Jesus is calling us.
那我们今天只是每天的这样去祷告，并没有想到主耶稣是怎样的 喊我们回来。
We forget about our sin, we forget about our weaknesses, but Jesus is calling us, be reconciled to me, be reconciled.
那我们忘记了我们的罪，我们忘记了我们的软弱，但是主耶稣却一直 在呼叫我们要回来与他和好。
Now let's turn to Romans chapter 8.
我们翻到罗马书的第八章。
Romans chapter 8 verse 26.
罗马书第八章的第二十六节。
Verse 26.
第二十六节。
Here it tells us the Holy Spirit helps us in our weaknesses.
那在这里提到了我们的软弱有圣灵帮助。
The Holy Spirit himself makes intercession for us.
那圣灵也亲自替我们祷告。
With groanings which cannot be uttered.
他用说不出来的叹息替我们祷告。
Groaning, is it happy or not happy?
那如果是这样的叹息是快乐的呢还是不快乐的？
It's not happy, isn't it?
那肯定是不快乐的。
Yeah.Jesus is our elder brother, right?
那主耶稣是我们的是我们的长兄。
He's praying for us, you know.
他在为我们祈求。
It's like I said, Aiya, why is he like this? Why is she like that?
那他就他就一直在替我们叹息，为什么你还是这样呢？
不是为什么他还是这样子？
为什么他还是这样子
？Because he's praying for us, right?
因为他在为我们祷告。
Why he not learning from me? Why he's not willing to suffer? Why is he not willing to repent and be holy like me? Why?
那为什么他不愿意学习我的榜样？为什么他不愿意悔改？为什么他不愿意回转来向我来和我一样圣洁
？But today, when Jesus has brought us to be one with him.
那所以今天当主耶稣来使我当使我们与他合为一的时候
Then we need to let Jesus do his work to make us holy.
那我们要能够让主耶稣来完成他的工作使我们得以成圣
I don't know if you have this experience.
那我不知道你是否有这样的经历
Have you had this experience before?
那你有这样的经历吗
When you're praying,
当你祷告的时候
The Holy Spirit say to you,
那圣灵对你说
I don't likeThis point of yours.
我不喜欢你身上的这样的一点。
对 ，I don't like this.
我不喜欢你这样继续的这样
做。Have you experienced this gentle revelation? God say, I don't like how you think. I don't like your mentality.
那你们有没有很被神这样温柔的提醒过？我不喜欢你这样的想法，或者不喜欢你这样思考的方式。
You see, Jesus is actively.Helping us become more holy.
那主耶稣在非常积极的来使我们能够更加的圣洁。
So therefore, it is important to follow what is written in God's word, just like Jesus.
那所以我们就要能够和主耶稣一样去按着神的话语去行。
You know, Jesus did not come down from heaven to do his own will.
那我们知道主耶稣来到从天来到地上不是要行他自己的旨意。
Today, if we want to partake of salvation as well as serving the Lord,
那今天若是我们想要与救恩有份，或者是我们也要想侍奉神的话
，we ought to follow Jesus.
那我们就要遵随主耶稣的榜样。
Follow the pattern he revealed to us.
就要能够遵从他启示给我们的规模。
As he is bringing us into glory.
那他要在将我们带进荣耀中。
We ought to carefully follow the pattern of salvation.
那我们就要小心翼翼地跟着那得救的规模。
We must not depart from it as we are serving him.
我们不要能够，我们在服事上也不能够偏离。
Let us not neglect our salvation.
我们不要去忽略我们的救恩。
Let us sing him.
我们来唱诗。
364。
第364首。
Those who have strayed
Find that Jesus did not neglect our salvation.
那我们知道主耶稣并没有忽略我们的救恩。
I don't know if you have thought about it like this.
那我不知道我们是否有这样的想过。
We say, God, you already manifest in the flesh. That is enough.
那我们想说，神你已经道成了肉身，这已经足够了。
You already took my sin upon you and suffered a sinner's death. That's enough.
那你已经将我的罪归到你身上，你虽然是无罪的，却已经替我们而死，这已经够了。
You already resurrected and gave us your blood.
那你已经复活，并且将你的血赐给我们。
You already gave me eternal life.
你已经赐给了我们永生。
And you already gave me the Holy Spirit,
你也赐给了我圣灵。
You already forgive so much of my sin.
你已经赦免了我许多的罪。
Do you know what?
那你知道什么吗？
Jesus does not sit in heaven and say, "Okay, I've done my part. Now you do yours."
那主耶稣并不会坐在天上说，我已经完成了我的部分，你完成自己的吧。
He doesn't do that.
他不是这样做的。
Maybe we do that, isn't it?
那可能是我们这样做。
Yeah, I told you.
那我已经告诉你。
I remind you already.
我已经提醒你了。
I already humble myself to.Correct you,
那我已经谦卑自己来想办法使你能够改正了。
Yeah, I already do my best.
那我已经做尽我所能了。
It's up to you.
那剩下的就靠你自己了。
Thank God, Jesus is not like us. You know?
但是感谢神，主耶稣和我们并不一样。
Jesus does not give up on us so easily.
那主耶稣不会轻易地放弃我们。
So we must not give up on each other.
那所以我们也彼此不要互相放弃。
And do not give up on ourselves.
那也不要放弃自己。
Let us not neglect our salvation.
让我们不要忽略了离弃自己的救恩。
Let's kneel down and pray.
我们一起跪下，同心祷告。
In the name of Lord Jesus Christ, we pray. We thank God our session ends here. We have no.
感谢神，我们的这一堂课到此结束。
We have no announcements. God bless.
那我们今天晚上并没有新的报告，愿神祝福各位。